Aaron from North Alabama Disc Golf, and this is the Music City Open, beat here in Nashville, Tennessee. This final round is at Seven Oaks Disc Golf Course. Video sponsor Halo Disc Sports, one of their sponsored players right there, Will Schusterick. They got a new tour bag. Got a couple videos coming up. One of them will show that new bag off. Starting on hole one, it's about 300 feet, and Will Schusterick has the box. Will's playing a spike hyzer, as I think everyone else will here too. It's pretty much the only route. Got to throw it around the trees. Disc finishes a little right. We'll have a 30-footer to start the round. This is Todd Bagwell, a 985 rated player out of Bartlett, Tennessee. He's following Will up. And that's a great way to start. 20-footer for his birdie. This is Matthew Blakely, a 1,007 rated player from Lebanon, Ohio. So, if he doesn't live in Tennessee, that was a pretty long drive to come play. He starts out well, too. Here's Joey Lutz, 1,011 rated out of Chattanooga, Tennessee. He's become one of the more known names and popular players lately. And he'll have a long putt. He caught a tree, threw his disc a little long. Here's Tyler Wammack from Horn Lake, Mississippi, 979 rated. And he caught that tree, too, so he'll have the longest look to start the round. Gives it a chance, but the wind grabs it. These open holes to start the course were quite windy. Will from 30. Just a little low. Have a drop in for the par, though. Here's Todd to pick up a quick stroke on Will. Great putt, spin putt, and that's the way to do it when you're in the wind. Tyler hits his comebacker. Matt for birdie. So we have Todd and Matt both carding birdies, and they started off second and third, so they pick up a quick stroke on Will. Everyone else taking their three. You can see a nice little view of the gallery here. There's a great community of disc golfers in Nashville, and there were a lot of people that came out to watch. This is hole two, the middle pin position, 365, playing a flex Anheuser shot into the wind. And after you crest this hill, it's downhill, so it's not that hard to make the distance. But this throw is all about the shape of your shot, and that looked pretty good from Todd. You can see just how windy it is on these holes right there, those elevators up and down with the wind. Can be difficult. Will opts for the flick. And that looks like a pretty solid shot. I mean, it was low, and that's how you want to play it in the wind. Probably got a bit of carry back up to the basket. Same looking throw from Joey. Looks like Tyler's going flick too. Taking a wider route, which you can do here, especially with the wind pushing it from left to right. But he might have gone a little long. Todd's birdie bid just left and short, probably the top of the cage. Pretty close shot from Matt, too. Tyler from about 40 or 50. Decent run, just left. Joey picks up the birdie. Will gets one too, so those low flicks were definitely the way to go in that windy condition off the tee. Looks like everyone else is just going to clean up for their threes. On to hole three, but they're playing to four's basket, and I estimated it to be about 500 plus feet. Will's got a two-stroke lead on Todd. This first throw is a placement shot. You're trying to hit the fairway to give yourself a clean look. Pretty good from Will. Joey's up next. Looks like he's just doing the exact same thing. Todd is going to opt for the backhand. So that'll be a pretty big Anheuser. The hole goes from left to right, and that looks like it's working really well. It may have even gone into the woods beyond the fairway, which, even if it's that far down, it's not too big of a deal. Matt's going for the inside route, which is there if you can hit it. But there is out of bounds on the left side, and I think he went out of bounds there. Your shot definitely has to shape left to right, or you'll be in trouble. Really good looking throw from Tyler. Now you can see the upshot these guys have to make. Joey had the farthest look. And it can be difficult with all those trees guarding the pin. It's one thing about this course. This is the most wooded course I've ever been around, personally. Will grabs a tree, ricochets off, a little bit high. Looks like Tyler's throwing a nice shot. Clears the trees. He'll probably have a circle's edge look. Matt's taking the roller. Great choice of shot right there. Probably didn't have a whole lot else, and that worked for him. Looks like Todd's in a little bit of jail, but he'll have a look. Trying to do that roller just like Matt, and that works out. Probably about 28, 30 feet or so. Here's Will from about 60 feet. Great make from about 60 feet. Huge putt from Will. Keeps him with that two-stroke lead, at least, because Todd and Matt are both parked for their threes. Joey has a long look for three. Can't quite turn it over enough. Good putt from Matt. This is the first time I've ever seen or heard of Matt, and really impressed me with his putting. Solid player. Just right side for Tyler. He'll be taking a four. Good conversion from Todd, especially with being in the woods like he was. Joey drops in. That was a four. On to hole four, and this is where it might be a little bit confusing because now we're on hole five's basket. Starting, we're playing hole five, but it's only the fourth hole of the tournament, and it is 440 plus feet through a lot of trees. And that seems to be a preferred route that Will took there. He just caught an early tree. I think Todd's going to be shooting for that one as well. Throws it a little higher and gets clean. He'll have a decent look for his upshot. Not a great shot from Joey. I think he was trying to take that center route, but just threw outside of that tree. Really early tree. First tree for Matt. That'll be a difficult upshot. Same tree for Tyler, the one he was trying to get around. Decent looking upshot from Matt. He got some distance. It may not have been the line he wanted, but he did get down the fairway. Tyler's going with the overhand. And again, not as much distance as he would have wanted, but it got him back into the fairway. Same goal here again, just cut off all this distance. Find some kind of gap between these trees. Joey taking a roller. There you can see the basket they're all shooting for. He gets it down the fairway, but he's not going to really have a putt. Early tree for Will. You could hear he wasn't happy about that one as soon as he let it out of his hand. Technical shot from Todd, and he's going to like that. That's definitely within putting range. He could be picking up some strokes here. Matt's third shot gets him about the circle's edge. Good looking upshot from Will. A little bit of a skip there, but he's at the circle. Tyler's just taking his medicine. He didn't have anything, so he's just pitching back into the fairway. Smart play. taking a jump putt approach. Maybe give it a chance, but definitely getting it close enough. Joey's third shot just puts it under the basket. Nothing wrong with a four on this hole. Good looking putt from Matt. Just came up a little short.
Good putt, Will.
That was a great save from Will. Puts in for his four. Not taking any extra strokes. Great three from Todd there. I think that was the only one on the card here. So we'll be picking up some strokes on everyone. Everybody just going to tap out. I think 1-3, a few fours, and 1-5 or 6 from Tyler, or 6 from Tyler. So he lost a few strokes there. We're on to hole number 5, 283 with a little look at the gallery that everyone is following. Nice looking shot from Todd. It's a hyzer, a little bit of a dog leg left. And that's a great looking shot from Will, too. Little gap to hit. These guys are making pretty quick work of it. Bad tree for Joey. But he's still out there. Ooh. Matt challenges that right side of the fairway, but he makes it. Little scary to start, but a good throw. Oh, good looking throw from Tyler, too. Just gets an unlucky tree. Mental error from Joey there. He was trying to putt around maybe 60 or 70 feet of those trees and ricocheted right off of one of them. Todd from about 45 feet. Just right. He should be under the basket. Here's a look at Will from about the circle's edge. Just a little bit high, skips off. You can tell he's not happy about that one. Those are the kind of putts he expects to make. Great putt from Matt. Gets the birdie. Comebacker for Will. Great concentration there. See, Will never takes his eyes off the basket. On to hole 6, 235 feet. Todd's only one stroke back, a Will now, and then there's Matt in the middle battling with Joey. Tyler a little bit behind everyone. This is 235, heading to the right. Not quite an extreme dogleg, but more of a smooth turnover shot. Looks like Will's nailed it. You can see the basket back there in the back right. This hole's set up nice for Joey. He's got a great forehand. Good looking throw from Tyler, too. That might skip in. Really close. Missed Matt's throw here. But as you can see, he got an early tree. Parks his upshot, though. Great upshot. Don't even think Todd was trying to run at that. Just use the jump putt form to get him close. Great putt from Will. That was probably right at the circle's edge, maybe about 33 to 35 feet. Great putt. Good three save from Matt. His upshot left him about 30 away. See if Tyler can convert. Good birdie from Tyler. That's how you come back from a 6. Joey for his birdie. Automatic. He's a pretty quick player sometimes. Takes his time, but when he decides he's going, he throws quick. On to hole 7. This one's 426 feet, and this is definitely the epitome of poke and hope. Just throw your drive and see if you can beat trees. And Will got a tree down there, but everybody's going to get a tree except for Joey. He sees a line, and he hits it perfectly, and it flexes back. He parked this hole. A little bit shorter there than you ideally want for Tyler. Fortunate kick for Matt. Kept some forward momentum. He'll have a good look. Same for Todd. Those are pretty fortunate kicks and all you can hope for. Tyler's the farthest out. And now you can see why this is so poke and hope. There's an absolute shield of trees guarding this basket. And I think Tyler was trying to get around him, but just threw it a little wide. Great navigation there. Throwing it right through a tiny little gap for Matt. An overhand from Will. And it cuts back a little bit to the left. He probably didn't want that. He left him about himself about 30 to 35 out uphill. So that'll be a challenging three. Great shot from Todd. Here's Tyler's upshot, second upshot. It looks like he got down there. He'll be putting. He had a long one, but just kicked it off a tree. Another great conversion from Will. Just threw it up high, let it fall. That's a three. And that is a two, which might as well be considered an eagle. I didn't see the other cards, but I would venture to say that Joey might have had the only two there. Short putt miss from Tyler. Matt drops in. And we're moving on from probably one of the most difficult holes on the entire course. On to hole number 8. It's 402 feet. It's a dogleg right, so a flick is a great throw, and Joey has thrown a perfect drive. And then it's about another 150 plus 200 feet uphill. So a turnover is definitely the way to go. It's the only way to go. That or a flick. Good looking shot from Will. High turnover from Matt. Looks like it got down there. I didn't see it kick off of anything. And a great looking shot from Todd. And a bad tree. As soon as I said that, I pretty much niced him. Wide flick from Tyler. And the trees and Seven Oaks here are taking their toll. He's already lost a few strokes on this hole. On his fourth throw, he does get back in the fairway. I think we've all been there before. This course and all the trees can get you pretty quick if you don't focus and pay attention on every shot. Even Todd right there, I mean, from trees on one side, bounces to the other. Good looking upshot from Will. Todd's third shot. Good kid. Takes an overhand roller. Gets a fortunate bounce. Kicks him towards the basket. This is Joey's second shot. So his first drive was perfect. Long putt from Tyler. Good form. Stops it beside the basket. And Matt must have had an even longer drive than Joey. I think that was his second shot. Short putt miss from Todd. You can tell he wanted that one. Can't miss those if you're trying to catch Will. Good putt, Will. Good three from Will. Same with Matt. It'll be a five for Todd, three for Joey, six for Tyler. Going on to hole 9, which is hole 8. 258 feet, and it is a dog leg spike shot. Joey gets the tree that you're trying to get around, so we cut it just a little bit inside. The play is definitely like Will just threw. Throw it high, throw it turned over, give yourself a chance to beat the trees. And he does. He's down there. Looks like Matt got the exact same line. And it would have had a similar result, but it went a little more straight, a little farther, and grabbed a tree. Really high approach route from Todd, and that works out perfectly. Ooh. Tyler's trying to do the same. Swings it out a little right, gets a bad kick. Just unlucky. Could have kicked right or straight, but it kicks the other way. But he gives it a run. That's a great upshot. Joey's upshot comes up short. So this is his long approach for a three. Gets it down there. He'll have a comebacker for a four. Good looking run from Matt, just right though. Misses his comebacker. So that's going to be a four for him if he puts in. Joey puts in for his four. Good save from Matt. Stop the bleeding. Todd gets his birdie. And Will was closer than everyone. He's going to get his birdie. Good three from Tyler. It's one of the shorter holes in the course, but it's definitely challenging. Going on a hole 10, 320 feet. And Will's now got four strokes on Todd. This is one of the more open holes on the course. It's just a nice, soft 300-foot turnover shot. Will makes pretty quick work of it when there's no trees challenging. Same with Todd. Throws it a little far, but he's at the circle's edge. He'll have a good putt. Good looking throw from Tyler, but it's just, it hung out a little bit left. He'll have a long approach, or a long putt rather. Joey's sidearm was about the same, just a little bit wide. The only trees you're really going to hit are to the left of the basket if you don't cut it in quick enough. Matt almost had it. He had one little branch to beat. Good run from Joey. Matt from about 40, 45 feet. Great putt. Long birdie. Todd for his birdie. And he gets it. He knows he has to capitalize on these opportunities to catch Will. Because Will's not going to miss his putt from right here. Joey and Tyler both going to put in for their threes. Another little shot of the gallery that's following. We're going to go on to hole 11. Only 230 feet, but there are a lot of woods, and it is a challenging throw to hit the gap and throw it a little bit uphill. Will hangs onto his disc a little long, and that's exactly what can happen at this course. There are so many trees. If you miss the littlest bit, it's not forgiving. Great looking shot from Todd. Parks it. Not a bad kick for Matt. He's at the circle's edge. Beautiful looking ace run from Tyler here. That'll be a nice bounce back from a few bad holes. Joey going with his forehand. And this hole definitely has the shape going right to left to throw a little forehand at it. Will opting for another overhand. Leaves him about 35 plus out. Just comes up short. And that's going to give Todd a chance to catch a few strokes. Tyler puts in for his birdie. Joey as well. And I don't think Todd's going to miss this. So the entire card here, including Matt right there with a great putt, is going to pick up two strokes on Will because this is a four. So Will bogeys, everyone else birdies. We're going to go on to hole 12. And the long disc, or the long pin here says 314, but we're playing past that. I estimate this hole at about 500 feet because it's definitely a two-shot hole to get to the basket. Todd grabs a tree. That was the tree he was trying to go inside of. Matt hits the exact same tree. Tyler might have been thinking that's the tree he needs to go inside of, and then hits the tree in front of it. So no one's got the gap yet. See if Joey can get it. He does. Hits right through the gap. Perfect drive for this hole. Good looking drive from Will. He goes inside of all of it, throws a nice spike, and ends up on the left side of the fairway, which is where you want to end up. Tyler's just trying to get to the second fairway. Ideally, your second shot is looking at the basket. Like Matt's right here. The basket is at the end of this trail. And that looked like it was going to be a great roll, but it came down right on a log. Decent looking upshot for Will. Joey had the best drive by far, and he's left himself with the opportunity for a three. Third shot for Matt. And he's up there. Now that you can see the basket, after a couple throws from each player, you can see this is definitely a challenging hole. Great upshot from Todd to weave it through there with an S-shot flick. Looks like Tyler's trying to follow suit. And he does. Great shots. Will, again with his putter, holds onto it a little bit. And that'll be another stroke at least if Todd can drop his in. Great putt from Joey. Three on this is about it. It's the best you can do. You're not getting a two on this hole. So Joey's going to pick up some strokes on everyone. Todd drops in to pick up a stroke on Will. So he's only one back now. And we're on to hole 13, which is hole 12. 329 feet. And it's a big spike. We're playing from an alternate tee here. Todd's going for the inside hyzer, not quite the high one. Matt opting for the high hyzer. But it is a guarded pin, so even if you throw a good shot, there's a chance you can get a tree. Tyler here takes his putter, but it flips a little bit on him and doesn't get that glide to the left. Goes straight into the other side of the fairway, hits some trees. Will's shot didn't quite get the glide either. It fell out of the sky, ended far back. And not a great upshot. Maybe that wasn't a great disc choice. It flexed out earlier than he wanted it to. Todd's just laying, or not Todd, that was Tyler, just laying up for his three. Todd's doing the same thing. Will with a long look for his par. Great looking putt. Almost went in. That's about as close as you can get. Joey parked it. That's a two. So two holes in a row. Joey's picking up some strokes on everybody. Matt as well, getting his birdie. Todd with a drop in three. He's going to pick up another stroke on Will. So after this hole, with just six or seven holes left to play, Will and Todd are tied, 193. Matt, seven back, then Joey, four more back, and Tyler's lost a few strokes. This is a 765-foot hole. Two long fairways to beat. This first one, you got to get through the trees and beat some other obstacles, trying to get into the second fairway. Matt's disc comes out a little bit early. He's going to be in the rough on the side of the fairway. low straight shot from Todd. Pretty controlled throw. A very pretty controlled throw. Ends up in the exact same spot that Joey did. Now, while they're in the other fairway, they'll have a difficult lie. Nice controlled S from Tyler. Ends up in the creek. A weird lie, but he did beat those obstacles. And he's in the next fairway. Will was trying to get as much bit off from that fairway as he could, throwing it high, but grabbed a little bit of foliage, dropped down. Matt got out and gave himself a clean look for the next fairway. That might be a little higher than he wanted, though. I think he'll be at the edge of the woods with about 100 feet left. Will taking the flick. Kicks out. He didn't like it to start with, but he got a good kick. Nice looking up shot from Todd. Don't even think he was trying to get all the way to the basket. Just be controlled and be in the fairway. Another roller from Joey. Turns over a little bit. Ends up in the left side of the fairway in the woods. And that was a high shot from Tyler. Ends up over in the trees. And as we see here in a second, it did not come down. Had to lean up pretty high to get a look at where this disc was. There it is. You can see it. So an unfortunate stroke for Tyler. Nice little out shot there. Gets himself to a place where he has a look at the basket. Nice third throw from Joey. Four is definitely acceptable on such a long wooded hole. Three would be spectacular, but take a four every single time. Matt's upshot comes up just a little bit wide and short. Will from about 80. Never had a chance. Buddy is parked, so he's going to move on to the next hole without any more strokes. Great looking putt from Matt, but just a little wide. Had a lot of chains. If he had got luckier right there, it might have stuck. Nice four from Joey. So Will and Todd both got fours on that hole. Going on to hole 15, 265 feet. And it's a straight throw with a lot of rock and cement as the ground, so you can definitely skip away. Todd's taking the hyzer at it. That's one way to eliminate some skip, so you don't shoot past the basket. But he ended up a little wide. Will's taking the hyzer as well. You can see it's coming in pretty nice. And he's going to end up about 30 feet in front of the basket, so he'll have a nice putt. Matt taking the more conventional straight route. Sends it a little wide. Gets a bad kick as well. Tyler as well. A little bit uncontrolled there. Maybe threw it a little bit too hard. Ended up on the right side. Nice upshot, though. Shouldn't have any problem with that to take a three. Just left from Joey. And just a little bit high from Matt. This basket so far, not so friendly. Todd had a long, sort of reaching look to run at it. Didn't give it too much of a chance, but he's up there. Will was even closer than I thought, so Will had pretty much a drop-in 15-footer there for his birdie. And that'll give him a little bit of a lead down the stretch. This hole is 400 feet plus. Hole 16, you see D there. Pin is 338 feet, but we're throwing past that across a creek, which is out of bounds. You can see it marked off there in red.
It's coming right at us. Yep.
And Will's drive comes up farther than you really want it to. You want it to land about 50 or 60 feet or feet short of that, either across the creek or on the other side, just to give yourself a good look. Not a terrible throw from Joey. He'll have a look. Good play from Todd right here to land in the first fairway and give yourself a look, a big look at the opening into the second one. Nice throw from Tyler. He's right where you want to be. Low shot from Matt, heading towards the creek. And he ends up about 2 inches away from the out of bounds. And you can see there the gap you're trying to hit and why you don't want to go too far down the first fairway. Joey's upshot gets a little bit out of control. Hits one of the earlier guardian trees. Will didn't have anything but an overhand through a tiny gap in those trees, and he made it. He's going to be inside the circle. And that was a pretty clutch moment going down the stretch to not lose any more strokes here to Todd. Everyone else just getting out of trouble, pitching up. Todd really needed that one. That was his opportunity to keep pace with Will right here. Will hits his 30-footer, creates more separation. That's 2 strokes. Good putt from Matt. We're on to hole 17, which is the real 17. 222 feet in the B pin left position, so these guys are trying to throw uphill with some right to left contour. Trying to get a little bit of a skip if they can. Good looking throws so far. Joey taking the turnover that he's liked so much, but grabs a tree. Heiser shot from Todd. Looks pretty good. Tyler's last up. Sends it out a little wider. Kind of hits that right edge of the fairway and grabs a tree. But puts his upshot up there. Long look from Todd. Gives it a chance. We drop it in for his par. Joey didn't quite throw it high enough. Hits the pole. And Tyler drops in for his 3. Matt and Will both moving on with 2s. So going into hole 18, Will has extended his lead back up to 3, and that's pretty much a surefire win for him. This is 535 feet at least, says by the tee sign, but I'm not sure if that's correct because this seemed a little longer than that. These guys are throwing through a tiny gap downhill into an open field, and they'll have to have a controlled upshot, and Will almost takes out some spectators. Nice looking throw from Matt. Not trying to do too much, just get it into the fairway and get a decent look. You can see the basket there across the creek. That creek is out of bounds. Joey turns over his shot just a little bit too much into the ground. He'll have a long upshot. Todd throws out a booming S shot, and this is going to be the longest drive of the group. That is ideal. He's only got about 150 feet less or less. And a decent look. Both Will and Matt are going to have to navigate some trees, but Todd is going to have a pretty big window. Long upshot from Joey, 400 feet. Think that went out of bounds into the creek. And again, Tyler's shot was just a little bit to the left. He's having some early release problems. Matt peers the gap. That's going to be a 3. Will isn't even trying to get across. He's got strokes to play with. Just lays it up to the left side. He knows if he goes out of bounds, that gives Todd a chance. And that is the reward for having such a great drive. Easy upshot from Todd. Joey tries to give it a run. Can't do it. And there you can see the disc in the basket. That's Will. Sorry, I didn't get over there. He canned his 40-footer across the creek. He threw it pretty fast. I was running over trying to get to him from Joey's putt. But he moved pretty quick. Joey puts in. Matt puts in for his three. Todd for his. And that was the last putt of the tournament. Will pulled out 207 over Todd's 210. Tyler lost one place. Logan Bowers, as everyone's seen in some of my videos, jumped up by a few strokes and took fifth place. And thanks everyone for watching the Music City Open. This was a great tournament to go film. One of the more popular tournaments around this area every single year. And please subscribe, like, and share. It helps these videos get more popular, my channel get more popular, and get out to more people. Thanks everyone for watching.